Now that we have our document nicely formatted, we want to add in a table of contents. I want to put that table of contents on a page all by itself. So I'm going to turn on these non-printing characters and put a page break in, insert, page break, so that I have a little title page here. Now I want to add another page break, insert, break, page break, so that this will be the page that we put the table of contents on. And down here, I want to get rid of that extra paragraph. Let me backspace there. So there's space above this because we put that in the heading paragraph. Now we've got a spot to put our table of contents. And the easiest way to do that is to go to Insert, Indexes, Tables, Index and Tables, click here, and click OK. And it grabs all our headings and puts them out there. It's a simple table of contents, the most basic one we can do. Now this table is nice, but it would be even nicer if I could just click on the word summary and have it jump to that part in the document. And right now it can't do that because this is a simple table of contents. So let's go down and look at our headings again. And when I click on Thunderbird, it's showing me it's in my heading. And down here in the lower right hand corner, I see an outline one. If you remember, when I created the my heading, I grabbed it. Let's modify and go into organizer. It's linked with heading one. Because if I look at the outline and numbering here, it's saying body text and none, but that doesn't really make the difference because I didn't change that. It's actually grabbing it from my heading one. When I take a look at what this is, it's telling me outline level one, numbering style, outline numbering. So that's where it's getting this outline one from, because I'm modeling my header off of heading one. That's an important part of where we're getting this outline one. And we'll go over this a little more in a little bit. So now let's go back to the top, back to our table of contents, and take this off. I'm hitting delete, and I'm getting an error message. I'm getting an error message because I need to click onto the table of contents here, go into Insert, Index and Table, Index and Tables, and yes, my Protect Against Manual Changes is checked. If I uncheck this, now I can delete this if I like. Alrighty. So that's what the Protect Against Manual Changes is. Let's go back and insert this again. And this time, we're going to put in some links. To do that, I need to go into Entries. Now it's going to be level one. Remember our outline level one. So that's what we want here highlighted. Now I'm going to click to the left of this E, clicking hyperlink, and it's telling me link start. Now I'm going to click to the right of the E in that little white box, click hyperlink, and it's going to hyperlink all my level ones. Clicking OK builds me that same table of contents, but now they're blue. And if I hover over it, we can see click, control click, opens the hyperlink. So if I hit control and click on summary, it takes me right to summary. So there is a quick and simple table of content with links.